Join Charles and Hillary Price as they journey to South America, from the Amazon River in Peru, to the markets of Central Bolivia, to the high Andes Mountains of Ecuador. Find out how God is using living truth to bring the gospel to the ends of the earth.
Welcome to Ecuador. This is the third of a special series of programs shot on location in South America, in which we're bringing you reports of what God is doing here and how we at Living Truth are able to participate. We're calling this series To the Ends of the Earth. When Jesus sent his disciples from Jerusalem to the ends of the earth, they would not have been able to get much further away than South America. Then, of course, unknown to them. Living Truth, translated into Spanish, is helping to bring the gospel to remote corners of this Spanish-speaking world through radio and television, through DVDs, CDs, the internet, and with books. We are bringing you here to meet some of the faithful men and women who are using Living Truth programs and resources to evangelize and disciple their people. I am in Quito now, the capital city. The Evangelical Church has been steadily growing here over the past 10 years. We want to show you how Living Truth is helping the local churches and is having an impact in Ecuador. Stay with us for the next hour, and we will take you to the ends of the earth.
You are watching a special edition of Living Truth, shot on location in Ecuador.
Another remarkable story goes back to the murders of five missionaries from the United States in 1956. Nate Saint, Ed McCauley, Pete Fleming, Jim Elliott, and Roger Uterin. In 1956, they flew into a remote area of the rainforest to try to reach the small, remote tribe of Rarani people. These people were known for their violence and had already killed many outside people who had ventured into their territory. At their first point of physical contact, the five missionaries were speared by warriors from the tribe. This incident received wide press coverage all around the world and was a major influence among evangelical Christians. It is estimated that up to 10,000 people went to the mission field in response to those martyrs. It is a story that has impacted me significantly since I was young. But the story does not end in death and wasted lives. Some of the widows risked their lives to go back to make contact with these same people, and in due course, many of them found Christ and their lives were transformed. It's a remarkable story which continues to this day. Today, there are many means of reaching this nation with the gospel. One key strategy is through media. HCJB Radio and Asoma TV are just two of the organizations that reach over the airwaves with the gospel. And I visited both of them to find out more.
Para erradicar la enfermedad. Esta información con la Radio de las Naciones Unidas.
Una cooperación
HCJB radio station in Ecuador was the first missionary radio station in the world. It's known as the Voice of the Andes, and it's the Andes Mountains that gave HCJB an advantage when it began broadcasting 82 years ago. The capital city, Quito, has a high elevation and is surrounded by even higher mountains. Antennas on these vantage points enable the shortwave signal to travel around the world. Today, the internet has taken over from shortwave, but radio remains popular and influential.
In our country, here in Ecuador, there are more than 900 radio stations between AM and FM. HCJB, out of all the 900 radio stations, it is the number two in the ratings of radio stations, and we have the most influence in our country, thanks to the Lord.
Does every home, every household pretty well across Ecuador have radio, even in the remote areas?
Sí. La radio es
radio is very strong in Ecuador. Our geography is very irregular. We have the Ecuadorian Andes, we have the rainforest, and radio is all over the place. A lot of media, such as television or internet, cannot get there, but the radio does.
Jeff Koistra is a missionary from the U.S. He works as an engineer at HCJB.
Now, we know that the whole media world has changed with the internet in particular, but radio, as we understand it, still has a big role to play.
We are producing content to go on the radio, but it's also content that we use on the web, so we can keep in line with changing technologies. Still, today, many, many, many people are listening to radio.
HCJB radio station believes so strongly in the power of radio that its mission now is to plant small radio stations throughout Latin America.
And what we do is help people who want to start radio stations or people who have started radio stations and need a bit more radio training. We provide courses for people and we help provide equipment to get a radio station up and running as well.
We produce radio programs and distribute them over the internet to those radio stations so that they can use them. And when they have questions regarding technical issues, we advise them about which equipment is the best for them to invest in, or any other technical questions they might have.
I think this is the most exciting dimension that we've discovered in coming to HCJB. The fact you're doing this throughout Latin America, small radio stations desperately need this kind of encouragement and advice and counsel and training.
Yes, we see the need and we try to fulfill that need with our experience because, thanks to the Lord, we have more than 80 years of experience and we want to share it with the smaller radio stations so they will keep growing for the benefit of God's kingdom by broadcasting the gospel.
Nearby, at the Asoma TV station in Quito, the hosts and crew are getting ready for a live daily program. Today, the special guest is Charles Price. The Asoma TV audience knows Charles because Viva La Verdad, the Spanish version of Living Truth, is broadcast on this station. It's a good fit.
Viva La Verdad está en el mismo rumbo que nosotros estamos pensando.
Vive La Verdad is on the same path we are on. Vive La Verdad speaks the Lord's word. It doesn't use flashy things to catch people's attention. We want people to know about God, who He is, because He's our Creator. Only Jesus is the way to get eternal life. That is what we want to have bridged.
Asoma TV began broadcasting 22 years ago. It's the only Christian TV station which broadcasts to the whole of Ecuador.
What influence is Asoma Television having throughout the country?
The influence of Asoma in our country is very big. There are many needs among the people. We have heard many testimonies of the influence that we have on people's lives. People that were waiting to commit suicide, broken homes being restored. We have seen people blessed by this ministry.
A team of 40 volunteer counselors talk with people who phone the television station in response to the programs.
¿Y si tu esposo podría venir, tu familia que podrían venir y estar aquí? Y además también conversando con ellos.
We talk with them. We give them the space to talk, and we listen to them with empathy, and of course, we refer them to God's Word. We open God's Word and read them Bible verses to show them support, and we pray with them.
Hasta las oficinas nuestras. ¿Es posible?
Cada oración, cada petición.
Each prayer request is written down on a small piece of paper and prayed for personally and on the air on our programs.
Como en los programas.
Y además también se hace muchas veces seguimiento.
We follow up as well, and we have seen restored families. Fathers who have come back to their homes. Children that are walking on better paths. And we've seen them working together in activities to restore the family as well.
De familia, de pareja.
Entonces, Asoma es una bendición para todos.
So Asoma is a blessing for all of them. And we received many messages of support. I think God put it in my heart to have correct doctrine. As Vive la Verdad preaches, we must have the right doctrine. So people believe and know God as He is. God.
Hay obediencia a Él. Hay dependencia en Él. El vino es su responsabilidad, no de ellos.
Living Truth is broadcasting in Ecuador, a half-hour Spanish language program on Asoma TV, and a half-hour radio program on HCJB. Through these broadcasts, many people from the capital of Quito to the high mountain regions, to the remote jungle areas, can hear the gospel of Jesus Christ.
In North America, we're used to big broadcast networks as our main source of television and radio programming. But in South America, in addition to some large networks, there are many, many small privately owned stations that broadcast in their own locality. These local radio and TV stations are a wonderful fit with Viva La Verdad. We have already seen how pastors are using radio and television to reach people who might not otherwise hear the gospel. Many have come to tell us that Living Truth provides the kind of Christ-centered Bible teaching that is widely needed, but presently missing here. I invite you to participate in this important mission. Together, we can help people in this country and in more than 20 other Spanish-speaking countries to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ through Living Truth. But we cannot do it without your help, your financial support and participation with us. I ask you to consider this and to spread the gospel here in South America.
Through the media, we are doing what was told to the apostles in Acts 1:8. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. To send a donation, please write to Living Truth, P.O. Box 91100, Bayview Village, Toronto, Ontario, Canada, M2K2Y6. On the internet, go to livingtruth.ca and follow the prompts. Your gift, large or small, is valued and helpful. Prayerfully consider support for Viva La Verdad. It is one of the most effective means of bringing the gospel to the ends of the earth.
I want to invite everyone to keep watching Vive La Verdad, a ministry that is training and equipping pastors so that people believe in our Lord Jesus Christ as the only way to know God our Father. For He is the answer to life.
You are watching a special edition of Living Truth, shot on location in Ecuador.
The process of translating and dubbing Living Truth into Spanish requires a great deal of skill. Fanny Castro, originally from here, Quito, Ecuador, has that skill, and we're fortunate to have her working on the Viva La Verdad team. Fanny not only brings her translating expertise, but also her love for God to the job. Needing a translator for the Living Truth visit to Ecuador, Fanny was the obvious choice. Her story shows us how God equips us for the work that He has prepared for us to do.
Fanny Castro is an invaluable member of the team on the Living Truth trip to South America. In Bolivia and Peru, she translated Charles's preaching.
My translator is Fanny Castro.
Mi traductora es Fanny Castro.
She is from Quito, but is now living in Toronto, in Canada, where I live. But I
wanted when Hillary led a workshop for women leaders in Peru, Fanny stepped in to help.
I think women need to cry a lot and they need to laugh a lot.
Video interviews in Spanish were no problem. Fanny was there. When the Living Truth team finally arrived at their last stop, Ecuador, it was an opportunity for Fanny to see her family again. Her father is a pastor. She comes from a strong Christian family, but she struggled to discover Christ for herself.
She's facing north because the north is a rich people.
When she showed Hillary around Quito, Fanny shared her story.
I was away for a little while, but then I had to come back and say, Lord, it's you and me. Not me trying to do things, it's you and me.
In her 20s, Fanny surrendered her life and career to God.
Our church used to have a small radio station to reach all the area, and I used to see my dad broadcasting radio programs and asking me to use my voice to do hello in the microphone, and I was so happy and proud to do that. And that's how I started loving media and enjoying the radio world and media world.
Fanny went to the media college run by the famous Christian radio station, HCJB. After graduation, she worked there as a translator.
I helped to change the programs from the U.S. in the Spanish version from here in Ecuador.
This Living Truth trip gave her the chance to reconnect with former colleagues and reflect on how the work at HCJB gave her the experience she was later to need at Living Truth.
It used to be very dangerous, but it's good to
Since she was a little girl, Fanny had always had an interest in Canada. And after some graduate studies in the USA, she sensed God leading her to apply to immigrate to Canada.
And I decided to go for it. Even in front of the person that was helping with the paperwork, before signing that, I said, like, give me 1 second. And I put my hands on the paper, prayed, and said, like, okay, now I can sign. The lady thought that I was crazy, but later on, she saw how fast the process went, and she was like, you are the one who prayed. So I went to Canada, and I started from zero.
Like many immigrants, Fanny had a tough time starting at zero. She went to work at a retail store selling clothes.
Yes, I had second thoughts. Like, do you really want me, Lord, to be here? Why? I don't get it. And I'm here now, what? Selling clothes. So it was a time of just waiting. I said, okay, I'm just, you and me, that's what I prayed. Let's keep going.
Just talk to me a little bit about the cost of leaving here and going to a foreign country and leaving that warm embrace of your beautiful family. What does that cost you?
It is hard. I miss my family. You met them. They are amazing. I miss to see my niece and my nephew growing up. That is what I had to pay, but I had to make a decision to follow what the Lord was telling me. And it is a high cost. It is really painful. To start in nothing, it's an amazing experience of dependence in the Lord.
At what point did you begin to feel, yes, now I know why I came?
When I got involved with Living Truth.
Fanny learned about Living Truth through the People's Church in Toronto. At first, she volunteered and later was hired to translate the sermons of Charles Price into Spanish. She had to be bilingual, understand theology, and have a cultural knowledge of all of Latin America.
I have to read it and make it mean something for someone in Latin America. And it's hard because we're in so many countries that we speak Spanish, but the same word in Spanish can mean one thing in Colombia, another thing in Guatemala, another thing in Chile, another thing in Ecuador, another thing in Peru.
Once the translation is complete, Fanny oversees the recording of the sermons.
Aquí es donde inviertes tu vida en el Señor Jesucristo para pagar tu culpa y pecado.
Marco Vergara is the Spanish voice of Charles Price. His timing needs to be perfect. When his voice is synchronized with the video, Charles appears to be preaching in Spanish. Now, 4 years later, she's left her job selling clothes and has become an indispensable member of Viva La Verdad. But God didn't just provide work for Fanny in Canada. He had even more plans for her.
He blessed me with an amazing husband, who is my family now. And I said, that's the most amazing blessing because I don't deserve such an amazing man next to me and be part of his ministry. And being now a pastor's wife, it's only because of the Lord. I've seen his hand in through all the process, although I didn't know what was going to happen at that time. And I don't know what is going to happen tomorrow, but I know that he is in control.
Fanny's story is a great example of how God creates beforehand work for us to do. God is blessing Living Truth through Fanny's contribution to the program. We hope you too will join us in this important venture.
Problems facing the South American Evangelical Church today is the lack of trained pastors. Most of them have to do a daytime job to support their families, in addition to engaging in almost full-time work as a pastor. These church leaders and pastors need encouragement, resources, and training. Living Truth is helping fill that gap with a program called TEL, Training and Equipping Latin American Leaders. The vision comes from Living Truth's Spanish manager, Carlos Lopez.
Carlos Lopez traveled with the Living Truth team in South America. In every country, he organized conferences for pastors and church leaders, the TEL program.
So TEL program is a project to help them to grow in the spiritual knowledge and relationship with God, and to provide this knowledge and relationship to all the members of the congregations.
At each conference, pastors receive a gift package of books by Charles Price, translated into Spanish. They also get DVDs and CDs and solar-powered audio devices programmed with 100 messages from Charles, plus the entire Bible in Spanish. For many, this is the first time they have received gifts like these.
First time in my life that I receive a blessing like this. It brings me joy, pleasure, and excitement to go and gather the people to share with them the word of the Lord.
Many small Latin American churches operate on a shoestring and can't even afford books.
The books that they gave me as material for discipleship and everything else is another great blessing that I have never expected in my life.
I am very excited to have found materials, and through this we can train more workers.
Carlos came up with the idea for TEL when he realized that Latin American pastors had little or no theological training and could not afford teaching materials.
Many will not be able to attend a Christian university or biblical seminary, but all of them will need solid training, biblical training.
Books by Charles Price give the biblical training that these pastors need. They can then follow the biblical command to go and make disciples in their own communities.
Christ for real, that is for discipleship. So we help the pastors to start a discipleship program. Many of them say, I never before start a discipleship program because I didn't have material for this.
I believe the great contribution of VLV in Bolivia and Latin America is to help the Latin American church to create a discipleship culture.
Living Truth can come alongside Latin American pastors and church leaders and provide much-needed teaching materials. Books come with lesson plans and study guides. They are an easy-to-use teaching program.
I enjoyed it all, but more the leadership part. Because I work in a small church, now I will be able to add more and more with the books I am bringing. I will be able to oversee that small church to help it grow.
At the conference, the pastors are taught how to use the materials. Each package costs about $250, but they are distributed free to the pastors. We hope that you will support us financially in this vital extension of the Living Truth broadcast program.
A Christian media ministry such as Living Truth and our Spanish version, Viva la Verdad, has as its foundation the production and distribution of television and radio programs which go out on many stations all around the world. And on that foundation, Viva la Verdad has developed a whole range of different kinds of media to communicate the gospel. DVDs and CDs are made from the programs and distributed for personal use and in Bible study groups and in churches. We have a Spanish website which attracts seekers, especially younger people who are searching for explanations and meaning to life. We have a Facebook page to interact with people across the continent and also an active presence on YouTube. Solar-powered audio players loaded with the entire Bible in Spanish, along with 100 Living Truth messages, are made available to people who are working in remote communities where literacy is low. Some books have been translated into Spanish and printed inexpensively in the countries where they will be distributed. Through local pastors' associations, Living Truth is providing training for pastors, enabling them to return to their home communities with materials to help them better disciple the believers. We see fruit from the support we provide for them, yet the opportunities are almost endless if we have the materials available. I ask you, from the safety of your living rooms across North America, to take this opportunity to help train and equip pastors, and to provide increasing Christian presence on the internet and bring more Bible teaching programming into the homes of people through radio and television stations. May I ask you now to continue your support for this important mission to the millions of Spanish-speaking people around the world and to the ends of the earth.
Through the media, we are doing what was told to the apostles in Acts 1:8. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. To send a donation, please write to Living Truth, P.O. Box 91100, Bayview Village, Toronto, Ontario, Canada, M2K2Y6. On the internet, go to livingtruth.ca and follow the prompts. Your gift, large or small, is valued and helpful. Prayerfully consider support for Viva la Verdad. It is one of the most effective means of bringing the gospel to the ends of the earth.
So many people talk about how radio has just helped them in their spiritual growth, especially. And when you combine radio with traditional missions and evangelism, I think it's a powerful tool.
Many people work behind the scenes with cameras and microphones, and they have experienced true peace. I invite you to be part of this ministry so you can enjoy Jesus' love. Now you know that you are invited to live the truth in this ministry. Vive la verdad.
Vive la verdad.
Stay tuned now for a message from Charles Price at the Christian and Missionary Alliance Church of Guayaquil, Ecuador.
I'm going to read from 1 Samuel chapter 7, beginning at verse 1. So the men of Kiriath-Jearim came and took up the ark of the Lord. They brought it to Abinadab's house on the hill and consecrated Eleazar his son to guard the ark of the Lord. The ark remained at Kiriath-Jearim a long time, 20 years in all. Then all the people of Israel turned back to the Lord. So Samuel said to all the Israelites, "If you are returning to the Lord with all your hearts, then rid yourselves of the foreign gods and the Ashtaroths and commit yourself to the Lord and serve him only, and he will deliver you out of the hand of the Philistines." So the Israelites put away their Baals and Ashtaroths and served the Lord only. Out of verse 10, while Samuel was sacrificing the burnt offering, the Philistines drew near to engage Israel in battle. But that day the Lord thundered with loud thunder against the Philistines and threw them into such a panic that they were routed before the Israelites. The men of Israel rushed out of Mizpah and pursued the Philistines, slaughtering them along the way to a point below Beth Kar. Then Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen. He named it Ebenezer, saying, "Thus far the Lord has helped us." So the Philistines were subdued and they stopped invading Israel's territory. Throughout Samuel's lifetime, the hand of the Lord was against the Philistines. The Ark of the Covenant represented the presence of God amongst the people.
El arca del pacto significaba y representaba la presencia de Dios en su gente.
When God gave the ark to Moses, he said, "There I will meet with you, and there I will speak to you."
Cuando Dios dio el arca a Moisés, le dijo, "Ahí es donde yo me voy a encontrar contigo, ahí es donde yo voy a hablar contigo."
The ark was carried on the shoulders of the priests.
El arca era cargada en los hombros de los sacerdotes.
And when the tabernacle, which moves through the wilderness, was in one location, the ark was placed in the Holy of Holies.
Y cuando el tabernáculo era movido de un lugar a otro, el arca era ubicada en el lugar santísimo.
And it was called the Holy of Holies because God was there.
Y era llamado lugar santísimo porque Dios estaba ahí.
This is where they would meet with God.
Ahí es donde ellos se encontraban con Dios.
And if you remember the Old Testament story of the tabernacle and later the temple.
Y si ustedes recuerdan la historia del en el Antiguo Testamento en cuanto al arca y el tabernáculo.
You could not just walk into the presence of God in the Holy of Holies.
No, nadie podía entrar nada más al lugar santísimo.
You had to bring an offering, a sacrifice, and present it to God on behalf of your sins.
Tenías que primero presentar sacrificios, quemarlos para poder limpiar tus pecados.
And then it was the priest who went in once a year to the Holy of Holies.
Y había un sacerdote que iba una vez al año a ese lugar santísimo.
And on behalf of the people, he met there with God.
Y en nombre de todas las personas se encontraba él ahí con Dios.
You have to go back to chapter 4 to understand what happened.
Tenemos que volver al capítulo 4 para entender qué fue lo que pasó.
In chapter 4, verse 1.
En el capítulo 4, verso 1.
Middle of the verse, it says the Israelites went out to fight against the Philistines.
Nos menciona que Israel salió a pelear, encontró en batalla a los filisteos.
The Israelites camped at Ebenezer and the Philistines at Aphek.
Y acampó junto a Ebenezer y los filisteos acamparon en Aphek.
And the Philistines deployed their forces to meet Israel, and as the battle spread, Israel was defeated by the Philistines, who killed about 4,000 of them on the battlefield.
Y los filisteos presentaron la batalla a Israel, y trabándose el combate, Israel fue vencido delante de los filisteos, los cuales hirieron en la batalla en el campo como 4,000 hombres.
So the nation of Israel has been beaten by the Philistines, thrashed by them.
Así que la nación de Israel perdió ante los filisteos.
And the others of Israel got together and said, "Why did this happen?"
Así que todos los israelitas se reunieron y dijeron, bueno, entonces, ¿qué pasó?
They said in verse 3, "Why did the Lord bring defeat upon us today before the Philistines?"
Israel dijo en el verso 3, "¿Por qué nos han herido hoy Jehová delante de los filisteos?"
And then somebody had an idea.
Y de ahí algo interesante pasó aquí.
In the middle of verse 3, "Let us take the ark of the Lord's covenant from Shiloh so that it may go with us and save us from the hand of our enemies."
Y algo muy interesante pasó en la mitad del verso 3. Dice, traigamos a nosotros de Silo el arca del pacto de Jehová, para que viniendo entre nosotros nos salve de la mano de nuestros enemigos.
Now, there was a reason why they thought that.
Había una razón por la cual ellos pensaron eso.
There have been many times in their history when Israel had been in difficulty and they brought the Ark of God into the situation and God had freed them.
Hubo varias ocasiones en la historia de Israel cuando ellos estaban en problemas, ellos traían el arca y ahí fueron ellos liberados o salvados.
When they crossed the Jordan River, you may remember when Joshua led the people into Israel.
Cuando recuerdan la historia de Josué saliendo y trajeron el arca para cruzar el río Jordán.
The priests carried the ark of the covenant on their shoulders and went down to the Jordan River.
Los sacerdotes tenían el arca en sus hombros y iban a cruzar el río Jordán.
And as their feet touched the Jordan River, the water stopped flowing.
Y mientras ellos iban a caminar y tocar el agua se hacía a un lado para que ellos caminen.
And God took them through on dry ground.
Y Dios los llevó por medio de un camino seco.
And so they say in 1 Samuel chapter 4, let's take the Ark of the Covenant and it will save us.
Así que ellos agarraron el arca en este tiempo, no, perdón, ellos estaban en la batalla, entonces dijeron, traigamos el arca porque ella es la que nos va a salvar.
And so if you read the story, they put the ark on the shoulders of the priests.
Así que si seguimos leyendo la historia, ellos pusieron el arca en los hombros de los sacerdotes.
And in verse 10 it says, so the Philistines fought and the Israelites were defeated. Every man fled to his tent.
Así que en el verso 10 dice, entonces enviaron el arca de Dios a Ecrón y cuando el arca de Dios vino a Ecrón, los ecronitas dieron voces diciendo, han pasado a nosotros del arca de Dios de Israel para matarnos a nosotros y a nuestro pueblo.
And verse 11 says, the ark of God was captured and Eli's sons Hophni and Phinehas died.
Y en el verso 11 del capítulo 4 dice, y el arca de Dios fue tomada y muertos los dos hijos de Eli, Hophni y Phinehas.
Now, why was the ark captured?
¿Por qué fue el arca capturada?
Why didn't God give them the victory as he had on previous occasions when they'd carried the ark into a difficult situation?
¿Por qué fue que en esta ocasión Dios no les dio la victoria a ellos aunque ellos trajeron el arca y no fue como en las otras ocasiones en el pasado?
And you find the answer back in verse 3, middle of verse 3. It says, let us bring the ark of the Lord's covenant from Shiloh so that it may go with us and save us.
Y la respuesta está en el verso 3, el que leímos, que dice, traigamos a nosotros, decirlo, el arca del pacto para que viendo entre nosotros nos salve de la mano de nuestros enemigos.
Notice that. It, the ark itself, it will save us.
Noten en cuenta esto, que nos salve, es ella la que les iba a salvar, el arca.
Now if you go back to Joshua chapter 3 when they carried the ark through the Jordan, that was not where their confidence lay.
Si volvemos a Josué, cuando habla de la historia del pasar con el río, ahí hay algo diferente.
In Joshua 3 and verse 5, it says, Joshua told the people, consecrate yourselves for tomorrow the Lord will do amazing things among you.
Si vemos en Josué 3, verso 5, dice, y Josué dijo al pueblo, santificaos porque Jehová hará mañana maravillas entre vosotros.
It is the Lord who will do amazing things among you.
Es el Señor el que hace las cosas maravillosas.
Not the ark which you carry, that is a symbol of his presence.
No el arca que están cargando, el arca solo es un símbolo de su presencia.
But it's just a box.
Pero es solo una caja.
It is God who's going to liberate you.
Es Dios quien los va a liberar.
1 Samuel chapter 4, they say, let us bring the ark of the Lord's covenant that it may save us.
Y vemos que en 1 Samuel 4, en el verso 3, ellos llamaron, se pusieron de acuerdo para que traigamos el arca del pacto para que nos salve.
So they have detached the symbol of God's presence from God himself.
Así que separaron el símbolo de la presencia de Dios, lo separaron de Dios mismo.
They're not trusting God, they're trusting the ark.
Ellos no estaban confiando en Dios, ellos estaban confiando en el arca.
There are many symbols that God gives us through Scripture.
Hay muchos símbolos que el Señor nos da a través de la Escritura.
But the symbol is always pointing to a substance, something different, something greater.
Pero estos símbolos siempre están apuntando a algo más grande, algo más profundo.
And the great danger is that we lose the substance, which is always to do with God himself, and we replace it with the symbol.
Y el peligro es que a veces nos concentramos más en el símbolo que en la sustancia que viene de Dios.
Let me illustrate that from the New Testament.
Vamos a ilustrar eso con el Nuevo Testamento.
God has given to the church several symbols.
Dios le ha dado a la iglesia varios símbolos.
One is the Lord's Supper, communion.
Uno de esos es la Santa Cena.
And Jesus in the upper room said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take it, eat it in remembrance of me."
Y Jesús en el aposento alto tomó el pan, lo partió y dijo, "Tomen esto en memoria de mí."
Now the symbol is the bread and the wine.
Ahora el símbolo aquí es el pan y el vino.
The substance to which it points is Christ.
Pero la sustancia a la cual eso debe apuntar es Cristo.
Remember me.
Acuérdense de mí.
Remember I died on your behalf. This is my blood, my body.
Recuerden que yo morí por ustedes. Este es mi cuerpo, esta es mi sangre.
I have paid in full for your salvation.
Yo pagué todo para su salvación.
So eat the bread and drink the wine to remind you of the body and blood of the Lord Jesus.
Así que el comer el pan y beber el vino te recuerda lo que Jesús hizo.
But what if you don't know what it is to be really reconciled to God in your own life?
Pero ¿qué pasa cuando tú no entiendes y conoces el ser reconciliado con Dios en tu vida y en tu corazón?
Can you still take communion?
¿Puedes todavía tomar la Santa Cena?
The answer is yes, you can.
La respuesta es sí, tú puedes.
But instead of the symbol pointing to the substance, the symbol replaces the substance.
Pero en vez de tomar el símbolo que apunta a la sustancia, es el símbolo el que se convierte en la sustancia.
And the all important thing becomes not, am I reconciled to God through the blood of Jesus?
Y de repente todo cambia, no recordar la reconciliación que tengo con Jesucristo.
But have I had it, the bread and wine?
Sino el debo tomar la Santa Cena.
I need to have it.
Debo tener la Santa Cena.
And it is dead.
Y entonces eso está muerto.
Because it's become detached from Christ himself.
Porque ya se separó de Jesucristo mismo.
What about baptism?
¿Qué en cuanto al bautizo?
Baptism is a beautiful picture.
El bautizo es una hermosa es un hermoso cuadro.
And baptism is a beautiful picture of identification with Christ in his death, burial, resurrection.
El bautizo es algo hermoso que simboliza la muerte en Jesucristo y el resucitar en él.
Now, baptism doesn't change you.
El bautizo no te cambia.
It is a symbol.
Es un símbolo.
All it does is make you wet.
Lo único que hace es hacerte mojado.
The substance is.
La sustancia es.
That the person who's being baptized is saying, I have been crucified with Christ. I've died with him.
Es que la persona que se va a bautizar está diciendo, yo he sido crucificado con Cristo.
I have been buried with him.
He sido enterrado.
And I've been risen to walk in newness of life.
Y he sido resucitado para vivir una nueva vida en él.
That's the meaning of it.
Es un símbolo, pero es un hermoso símbolo.
But what if a person doesn't know Jesus Christ?
Pero ¿qué si una persona no conoce a Jesucristo de esa forma?
They've never come to the point of saying, Lord Jesus, your death was my death and I died in you.
¿Qué si es que esa persona no conoce a Jesucristo? Yo morí contigo y tú has muerto por mí, yo morí contigo.
And to have been raised again to new life, which is the life of the Spirit of God within us.
Y no conoce el vivir, el ser resucitado y tener la vida de Jesucristo, vivir una nueva vida con él.
What if they don't know that?
¿Qué pasa si es que ellos no conocen él?
Can they still be baptized?
¿Pueden todavía ser bautizados?
Yes, but the symbol, baptism, will become a substitute for the substance, which is their relationship with Christ.
Sí, lo puede hacer, pero el bautismo se va a convertir en la sustancia y no su relación con Jesucristo.
And so the all important thing will become not are you walking in newness of life, which baptism portrays, but have you been done the act of baptism?
Y todo cambia en ser, ¿y realmente yo estoy caminando en la sustancia de ese simbolismo o se convierta solo un simbolismo que debo realizar?
But you can have communion just because I ought to, but not because of my relationship with Christ.
Yo puedo tener la Santa Cena porque toca la Santa Cena, sino porque yo tengo una relación con Jesús.
I can be baptized just because I think I should, not because I'm walking in newness of life with him.
Yo puedo ir bautizarme porque tengo que bautizarme, sino porque yo tengo una relación con Jesucristo.
And this is what happened in 1 Samuel chapter 4.
Y eso fue lo que pasó en 1 Samuel 4.
Let's bring the Ark of the Covenant.
Traigamos el Arca del Pacto.
The place where God said he would live amongst us.
El lugar donde Dios dijo que se iba a reunir con nosotros.
The symbol of his presence.
El símbolo de su presencia.
Let's take the Ark of the Covenant that it may save us.
Traigamos el arca para que nos salve.
And when they went into battle, it did not save them.
Y cuando vino la batalla, ella no los salvó.
They were beaten and destroyed.
Ellos perdieron y fueron destrozados.
And the Ark of God was captured.
Y el arca de Dios.
And it was taken into enemy territory for 20 years.
Y fue llevada a territorio enemigo por 20 años.
And this is where 1 Samuel 7 we read before comes in.
Aquí es donde lo que leímos antes aquí en Samuel viene.
Notice now they are seeking after God, not the ark, God.
Ahora noten que ellos en este verso ya no están acercándose al arca, sino a Jehová.
Verse 3, Samuel said, the whole house of Israel, if you are returning to the Lord with all your hearts, then rid yourselves of the foreign gods and the Ashtaroths and commit yourselves to the Lord and serve him only, and he will deliver you out of the hand of the Philistines. Notice that, not it will deliver you now, but he will deliver you.
Noten que ahí no dice, el arca les va a liberar, sino él les va a liberar.
And it says in verse 10, while Samuel was sacrificing the burnt offerings, the Philistines drew near to engage Israel in battle.
Y nos dice en el verso 10 que aconteció que mientras Samuel sacrificaba el holocausto, los filisteos llegaron para pelear con los hijos de Israel.
Now they've been fighting the Philistines many times and they've been beaten by them.
Muchas veces ellos habían peleado con los filisteos y muchas veces los filisteos les habían ganado.
So I imagine their knees were knocking.
Así que las rodillas de ellos estaban que temblaban.
Are we going to see a repeat of what we've seen in the past?
¿Vamos a ver otra vez que vamos a perder como en el pasado?
But no, because now our trust is in God.
Pero no, porque ahora su confianza estaba en Dios.
Not in it, the ark, but in God of whom the ark speaks.
No en el arca, sino en Dios, el cual es quien habla a través del arca.
And for the first time, Israel has defeated the Philistines in this series of battles.
Y por primera vez en esta serie de eventos, los israelitas ganaron a los filisteos.
And notice in verse 12,
y noten en el verso 12,
Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen. He named it Ebenezer, saying, thus far has the Lord helped us.
Tomó luego Samuel una piedra y la puso entre Mizpah y Shen y le puso por nombre Ebenezer, diciendo, hasta aquí nos ayudó.
Now that's a wonderful Hebrew word, Ebenezer.
Y esa es una hermosa palabra hebrea, Ebenezer.
It means God has done it.
Significa Dios lo ha hecho.
God has delivered us.
Dios es quien nos liberó.
But there is another Hebrew word they had after they were defeated in 1 Samuel chapter 4.
Y hay otra palabra hebrea en 1 Samuel 4.
When they were defeated, the priest Eli had died of shock.
En el verso 4, cuando el enemigo tomó el arca, el sacerdote Eli murió del impacto de él.
He had two sons, both of them had been killed.
Él tenía dos hijos y los dos hijos también fueron matados.
And the wife of one of them went into labor and gave birth to a boy.
Y una de las esposas de esos hijos, con toda esa noticia, entró en labor y dio a luz un bebé.
And in chapter 4, 1 Samuel 4 and verse 21, she named the boy Ichabod, saying, the glory has departed from Israel because of the capture of the Ark of God.
Y en el verso 21 dice que ese niño lo llamó Ichabod, diciendo, traspasada es la gloria de Israel por haber sido tomada el Arca de Dios y por la muerte de su suegro.
This is the other Hebrew word, Ichabod.
Esa es otra palabra hebrea, Ichabod.
It means the glory has departed.
Significa que la gloria se fue.
God is no longer active. God is no longer working.
Dios ya no está actuando. Dios se fue.
We are beaten and humiliated and defeated.
Hemos sido derrotados y humillados.
And you could write across Israel, Ichabod, Ichabod, Ichabod.
Y pueden escribir sobre todo Israel, Ichabod, Ichabod, Ichabod.
But in chapter 7,
Pero en el capítulo 7,
when they've humbled themselves before God,
cuando ellos se humillaron a sí mismos frente al Señor,
and they take the ark, but they say, He will rescue us, He will deliver us, He will save us.
Cuando quitaron su atención del arca y pusieron sus ojos en Jehová y dijeron, Él es quien nos salva, Él es quien nos libera.
And God intervenes.
Y Dios interviene.
Then they write the name Ebenezer, Ebenezer. Ebenezer.
Ahí sobre Israel se escribió la palabra Ebenezer, Ebenezer, Ebenezer.
God has done it.
Es quien ha estado trabajando aquí.
But there are many churches, and I see them all over the world.
Hay muchísimas iglesias y lo veo a través de todo el mundo.
And you write across them Ichabod.
Que uno puede escribir sobre ellas Ichabod.
The glory has departed.
La gloria ya no.
This is no longer a meeting place with God.
Este lugar ya no es un lugar donde uno se encuentra con Dios.
This church is dead.
Esta iglesia está muerta.
People come to meet each other, not to meet God.
La gente viene a encontrarse con otras personas, pero no con Dios.
And the great danger in your life and my life,
y el gran peligro de tu vida y la mía,
is that we can know and experience God in Israel as Israel had done in the past.
Que podemos llegar a conocer a Dios como Israel lo conoció en el pasado.
We can do direct business with Him.
Ahora podemos tener relación directa con Él.
But we start to trust not God Himself, but things, it.
Pero luego no nos desviamos a ya no confiar en Dios, sino en esas otras cosas.
And when we trust anything other than God, it leads to failure.
Y cuando nos empezamos a confiar en otras cosas que no son Dios, ahí comenzamos a fallar.
Who are you trusting?
¿En quién confías?
Back at home.
En cuando estás en casa.
Is it the Lord Jesus?
¿Es el Señor Jesús?
Who are we in fellowship with? Is it with the Lord Jesus Himself?
¿Con quién tienes comunión personal? ¿Es con Jesucristo mismo?
Or is it just with other Christians?
¿O es solo con otros cristianos?
Is that Christianity real on Sunday mornings, but it's not when we're away from other Christians?
¿Es nuestro cristianismo real solo cuando estamos el domingo a la mañana, pero no cuando estamos con otros cristianos?
Or are we living in a daily living relationship with Christ?
¿O estamos viviendo una relación diaria con Jesucristo?
We relate to the church, we relate to Christianity.
Nos relacionamos con la iglesia, nos relacionamos con el cristianismo.
We don't have a living relationship with Jesus Christ.
Pero no tenemos una relación viviente con Jesucristo.
Or we not only invite Him to forgive us and come to live within our lives.
Donde no solo confesamos los pecados y lo invitamos a que venga a vivir en nosotros.
But we day by day enjoy being loved by Him, loving Him back, speaking with Him.
Es una relación diaria donde cada día uno lo llega a conocer a Él y nosotros lo amamos a Él y Él nos ama a nosotros.
Where He becomes a living friend.
Cuando Él se convierte en un amigo real.
And so the encouragement of this chapter we had read in 1 Samuel 7.
Así que el ánimo, lo que nos anima después de leer este verso de Primera de Samuel 7.
Must be understood against the discouragement of 1 Samuel chapter 4.
Nos ayuda a darnos cuenta de la falla que podemos encontrar en Primera de Samuel 4.
Where trusting it has become replaced by trusting Him.
Donde el confiar en ello se convierte más importante que confiar en Él.
And enjoying His presence in our lives.
Y el disfrutar de su presencia en nuestras vidas.
We're going to pray together.
Vamos a orar juntos.
I don't know how God may have spoken to you this morning. I don't know if He's convicted you of something in your life. Good things that have become substitutes for God Himself. Outward behaviors that have become substitutes for a relationship with Jesus Himself. And where the word to describe your life would be Ichabod. But the invitation to all of us is to live in such a relationship that Ebenezer becomes true of us, that God is at work. We want to be Ebenezer Christians. Make this real for us, we pray. In Jesus' name. Amen.
We've now come to the end of our special series about Viva La Verdad, the Spanish version of Living Truth, shown in Latin America. Having traveled on this occasion to Bolivia, Peru, and Ecuador, I'm delighted and challenged by the dedication and faithfulness of many of the Christians that I've met here. Nelson and his wife in Bolivia center their whole lives and the life of their family around a tiny radio and television station. They broadcast Viva la Verdad, and people are responding. Carla, a university student in Santa Cruz, Bolivia, has committed her life to reaching people in poor communities, and she has an ambassador for Viva la Verdad on campus. Graciela and Uriel Sanchez lead a small Spanish-speaking church in Toronto and are thankful for Living Truth materials to help them disciple their congregation. Martin in Iquitos, Peru, gathered all the pastors in his area to work together to produce programming for a Christian radio and television station. And Pastor David in Racana visits remote communities in the depth of the Amazonian jungle to reach people for Christ. Now he is better equipped with Viva La Verdad's solar-powered audio players to help him in his ministry. We can learn so much from these servants of God. They remain faithful to God and to the mission he has given them, often in the face of huge difficulties. They are determined, they are steadfast, they are faithful. I invite you to support Living Truth financially and in prayer as we take Bible teaching television programs to the ends of the earth. We cannot do it without your help and your financial participation. Next week, we return to regular Living Truth programming. I hope you'll join us again. In the meantime, goodbye, and I trust you'll enjoy His presence in every part of your life this week.